With this system, we target to reach two of the most critical and important areas, which are the cockpit itself, where the driver sits, and also the engine compartment.
Welcome to our CrowdStrike safety series. Many of the components in an F1 car will get extremely hot during normal running of the car. If you combine this with the presence of highly flammable fluids, then the risk of fire is always a possibility. Fortunately, there are measures in place to help mitigate against this risk and ultimately protect the driver. Let's get into it. Luciano, thank you so much for joining us. What are we looking at right here?
So this is a fire bottle of the F1 car. So it's the main component of the fire extinguishing system. And this in particular is a 2015 fire bottle.
Whereabouts in the car is it located and how is it activated?
So the fire bottle and all the fire system is within the chassis of the car. And this component specifically can be in different regions. So for example, it can be in front or behind the driver's seat, or in the so-called leg box, which is the foremost section of the chassis of the F1 car. It can be activated in two ways, either by a button that is accessible to the driver, so it's within the cockpit, or by two hooks, we call them master switches, that are at the bottom of the principal rolling structure of the car. In that case, of course, won't be the driver activating them, but will be either a marshal or a mechanic.
How much of the car can the extinguisher actually reach when it's deployed?
With this system, we target to reach two of the most critical and important areas of the cockpit or of the car in general, which are the cockpit itself, where the driver sits, and also the engine compartment.
Now, in the event of an incident, there's a good chance that the electrical system in the car might be compromised. So how do we plan for that?
Yeah, that's a really good question, because this system needs a power source to be activated. So we want to exclude the eventuality where this cannot be activated in case of a crash. And of course, we gave it its own power source. So it's basically a standalone system. Actually, it can also be activated if the car is rolled.
So we know that any weight that you add onto the car is going to affect performance at the end of the day. So is it designed to be as lightweight as possible?
Yeah, we basically choose the right position inside the chassis and also the right shape that helps us to minimize the amount of weight. The bottle weighs only a few hundred grams.
So when you have to consider the overall performance of the car for a safety feature, does that mean that the entire system is designed in-house or is any of it a third party?
Yeah, of course, we prefer to design this system in-house because it can meet our needs and it can also be the shape that we want. So the design of this starts really early on and we can also design all the bits to be as lightweight and reliable as possible.
Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you.